But my whole point is, a lot of people are asking, like, you know, do you have to do medicine on a movie set in a comedy club or anything? All the fucking time. I always have, dude, so many times I go into doctor mode. It's like Godfather 3. Just when I think I'm out, they put me back in, you know? Everywhere, like, there, even recently, I was at a club in Phoenix. I don't know if you heard about this. A lady in the third row had a seizure in one of my stand-up shows. It wasn't because of a bad joke. I'm just saying. But TMZ reported this, and my publicist didn't want me to talk about it, which I didn't. But this, I want you to hear for the first time on Netflix, me talk about it in my own words, all right? I'm making fun of people like I normally do in my act. I have hoes to the left of me, hoes to the right of me. So I'm doing my shtick, like Asian Don Rickles. And there's this lady... the lady in the third row, and she was like, Mr. Chow, like, calm down, bitches, I'll get to you, it'll be fine. And they're like, no, someone passed out. And the lady fell down off her chair and she was just completely out. And I dropped the mic and I rushed over there and went into doctor mode. And it was the most surreal, sublime experience ever because I'm no longer a comedian, I'm a doctor. And the whole comedy club, we're no longer like a comedy club audience, we're like an ER of like nurses and aides trying to help her out. It was so fucking amazing. And I'm thinking to myself, like, look, oh my God, I may have to do CPR on this person. And I have to assess like the ABCs before you do CPR. You know, airway, breathing, circulation, not always be closing. It's a different thing. And I actually, if you go on YouTube, I have done work with the American Heart Association teaching medical students and nurses how to do hands-only compression CPR. You don't have to do mouth-to-mouth anymore. So it's true. This is a medical fact. I have two medical facts, all right? Number one medical fact, like, look, if you're ever in the position where, unfortunately, you may have to do CPR, you do chest compressions to the beat of Staying Alive, all right? It's like, ah, 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 staying alive, staying alive. It's true. And I'm thinking to myself, am I gonna have to BG this bitch? I don't. And then fortunately, I did not have to. She got up quickly. She had what they call a petite mal seizure. She's on medication. She had a history of epilepsy. By the way, she allowed me to tell this story. Her name is Christy. I actually flew her out to one of my shows in New York. She is doing fine. So everything, happy ending alert. Everything is good. But when we sat her up, we actually did a mental status exam with an audience member who happened to be a paramedic, and we're asking her questions because she's a little bit confused after the seizure. She's like, what's your name? Christy, where are you? Phoenix, who are you here to see? And then she turns and looks at me and then she vomits. So it's a normal response. And within minutes, the paramedics take care of her and she's fine. My whole point is, if you don't like any of my shit, you don't have to have a fucking seizure and a fucking... I can just walk out, bitch. I already got paid. I already got the check. And you know what? That's not even my worst seizure tale, all right? Dude, I did Ride Along 2 with Ice Cube and Kevin Hart. And we were shooting in a nightclub in Atlanta, 400 background actors in a nightclub, and a person has a severe generalized tonic-clonic seizure, and the whole nightclub clears out, and so I'm running towards a patient, and Ice Cube, who is the baddest motherfucker on the planet, he's amazing. Dude, he's fucking running towards a patient, too. We're like two outfielders going for the same ball, you know what I mean? And I tell you, he's taking out a belt, and I'm like, whoa, 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 you don't whip the patient, Cube. No, I don't know him. I'm more of a Reba McEntire fan. And he's right, running out to the patient, and then like he gets to him before I do. He puts the belt around the patient's mouth so he wouldn't choke on his tongue. Ice Cube, not me, saved the patient's life. It was amazing. Just a shout out to Cube. And to make small talk, I was like, so Ice Cube, I guess that was a good day.